Today, we'll be learning about the internal anatomy and organ systems of insects. As you'll soon find out, insects have a variety of internal body systems that aid in survival as well as help them excel as a biological class. The first of these organ systems we'll be covering in today's video is the digestive system. The digestive system is the bodily system responsible for the breakdown of food into simple nutrients. The process of digestion can be broken down into two categories: mechanical digestion and chemical digestion. Mechanical digestion is the physical breakdown of food through things like chewing and palpating, whereas chemical digestion is a process in which enzymes chemically dissociate food. External digestion employs both chemical and physical means to break down food. Physically, mandibles and maxillae grind down the food, and chemically, saliva breaks down sugars. The internal digestive system can be divided into three regions: the foregut, the midgut, and the hindgut. The foregut is specialized for food storage and predigestion. The foregut includes, in order, the salivary glands, the pharynx, the esophagus, and the crop. The pharynx and esophagus serve as a means of delivery for food from the mouth to the midgut, and the crop serves as a site of storage until food is ready to be digested. The ending of the foregut is marked by the proventriculus, a thick-walled organ that crushes food and deposits it in the midgut. This section is lined with cuticle and is thus shed when molting. The midgut is specialized for digestion and absorption, specifically through chemical digestion. There are two main structures that compose the midgut, the ventriculus and the gastric cecae. The midgut begins with the gastric cecae, which are tube-like structures protruding from the top of the midgut. As there is only limited space in the body of an insect, gastric cecae provide additional surface area for digestion. The bulk of the midgut is taken up by the ventriculus, which serves as a stomach, chemically digesting food. The hindgut is specialized for disposal and nutrient reabsorption. In the hindgut, water and vital salts are reabsorbed back into the body. The structures in the hindgut include the ileum, the rectum, and the anus. Additionally, hair-like extensions on the border of the hindgut and the midgut, called malphigian tubules, dump urine into the hindgut. The nitrogenous waste of insects is shed as ammonia in aquatic insects and as uric acid in terrestrial insects. An adaptation present in some insects with symbiotic microbes is the fermentation chamber, which houses the beneficial organisms and allows them to process or produce food. Like all other animals, insects need air. However, compared to our respiratory system, the respiratory system of insects functions very differently, without any lungs. The entrances of an insect's respiratory system are the spiracles, holes on the surface of the insect. These spiracles lead to the tracheae, tubes that carry oxygen to cells individually. The sites of gas exchange for these tubes are called the tracheoles. Tracheoles can be distinguished from the rest of the trachea due to their lack of cuticle lining. Holding spiracles open can be dangerous when toxins and irritants are present. So in order to limit the time spiracles are held open, insects have air sacs for oxygen storage as well. Insects possess an open circulatory system. What this means is that circulatory fluid is not carried by vessels, and is instead in constant contact with and bathing tissues directly. The dorsal vessel lines the top side of the insect, and this key circulatory structure is responsible for pumping hemolymph through the insect's body cavity. Hemolymph is the circulatory fluid of insects and is responsible for the transport of nutrients, hormones, peptides, and other vital chemicals throughout the body. The hemolymph also contains immune cells, called hemocytes, which function similarly to our own white blood cells. Bouncing off of that, pathogens present a serious threat to insects in the form of viruses, bacteria, toxins, and parasites. The insect immune system is responsible for the internal defense against these pathogens, as well as bodily repair through a series of chemicals and specialized cells. The hemocytes present in the insect's circulatory system are an example of cellular immunity. Cellular immunity is the immunity provided by hemocyte offense, in which either a single hemocyte absorbs an invader in a process known as phagocytosis, or multiple hemocytes encapsulate a larger threat. The other immune process possessed by insects is humoral immunity, in which peptides stored in organs known as fat bodies are released into the rest of the insect's body, triggering melanin production. Melanin is a dark, sticky chemical responsible for the pigmentation seen in humans, but is also important in the insect immune system. Melanin is used in defense and offense, both patching wounds and suffocating invaders. The fat bodies of insects serve many different purposes in the immune system and beyond, including peptide dispersal, microbiome hosting, hormone release, and detoxification, to name a few. Insects have incredibly short generation times, and most of the time, these short generation times correspond to shortened lifespans. In order to continue the insect class, these critters have to reproduce. The male reproductive system starts with the testes, organs responsible for the production of sperm. These testes are made up of smaller units called follicles where the sperm is produced. After production, sperm travels down a thin tract called the vas deferens into the seminal vesicle. The seminal vesicle retains the sperm until ejaculation, when the sperm travels down into the ejaculatory duct and is mixed with seminal fluid produced by the accessory glands. Seminal fluid from the accessory glands forms a spermatophore, a dense packet of sperm presented to females. Analogous to the penis, some insects have a chitinous external structure to aid in sperm dispersal called the ataegus. Some males also possess grasping structures for mating called genital claspers. Fertilization can occur internally with the ataegus or externally using a spermatophore. The female reproductive system starts in the ovaries, with egg production taking place on regions called the ovarioles. Once an egg is produced, it will travel down a canal called the lateral oviduct into a larger common oviduct. During fertilization, sperm is taken in via the vagina and is moved into the spermatheca for storage until it is released along with fluid from the accessory glands, creating a fertilized egg with a covering. Once the egg is ready to be laid, it moves into the ovipositor and is released from the insect's body. Obviously, the male and female reproductive systems of insects differ from each other in function, with one designed to create sperm and the other designed to create eggs, similar to humans. However, the reproductive systems of the two insect sexes share an alarmingly similar layout, with each system possessing a production organ, a tract, a storage duct, an area for deposition, and accessory glands. The nervous system is a bioelectrical grid responsible for detection of stimuli, interpretation of stimuli, and control of bodily systems. The nervous system is made up of neurons, which are cells specialized to carry electrical signals to parts of the body in a network. Much like the nervous system of humans, the nervous system of insects can be further divided into the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system, CNS and PNS for short. The CNS centers around the ventral nerve cord, a long channel of neurons along the underbelly of an insect. Clusters of neurons located in different segments of the body are called segmental ganglia and functions as small control centers. The brain is a cluster of fused ganglia in the head of an insect that serves as the main control center of the CNS. The PNS is made up of the rest of the neurons branching throughout the body that carry signals sent by the CNS as well as sensory structures that sense the outer environment. A few other systems of the insect body include the muscular system, responsible for internal body movement and locomotion, and the endocrine system, that regulates molting, behavior, and communication through hormone production. Well, everybody, that about wraps up this video on insect internal anatomy and organ systems. Please subscribe for more lessons in entomology, and leave a like if you learned something new. Until next time, this has been Crash Course on Entomology.